Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Kita mulakan kelas kita pada pagi ini dengan membaca Ummul Kitab Al-Fatihah. A'udzubillahi minasyaitonirrajim. Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Alhamdulillahi rabbil alamin. Arrahmanirrahim. Maliki yaumiddin. Iyyaka na'budu wa iyyaka nasta'in. Ihdinash shiratal mustaqim. Shiratal ladzina an'amta 'alaihim ghairil maghdubi 'alaihim waladdallin. Amin. Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Alhamdulillahirrabbilalamin. Wassalatu wassalamu ala sayyidina Muhammadin ashrafil anbiya'i wal mursalin wa ala alihi wa sahbihi ajma'in. Ya Allah, ya Tuhan kami, ampunkanlah dosa-dosa kami, ampunkanlah dosa kedua ibu bapa kami dan kasihlah mereka sebagaimana mereka mengasihi kami di masa kecil. Ya Allah, ya Tuhan kami, kurniakanlah kepada kami ilmu yang bermanfaat untuk diri kami, keluarga kami, agama kami, bangsa kami dan negara kami. Ya Allah, ya Tuhan kami, berilah kepada kami kejayaan di dunia dan di akhirat. Ya Allah, ya Tuhan kami, jadikanlah kami orang-orang yang bersyukur. Rabbana atina fi dunia hasanah wa fil akhirati hasanah wa kina azabannar. Alhamdulillahi rabbil alamin. Okey, alhamdulillah kita bersyukur kepada Allah SWT. Kita dapat masuk ke kelas kita pada pagi ini. Untuk minggu yang terakhir, minggu yang ke-14. Selamat Hari Raya Aidiladha saya ucapkan kepada semua. Hari ini adalah hari raya yang ketiga. Kita raya Adil Adha ni ada 4 hari. Jadi insyaAllah semoga kita semua diberikan kesihatan yang baik oleh Allah Subhanahu Wa Taala dan diberikan kefahaman yang baik untuk kita menimba ilmu. Jadi insyaAllah pada pagi ini kita nak bincang satu soalan satu soalan ataupun satu set soalan lah kalau sempat tapi mungkin satu set tu tak sempat lah kita tengok satu soalan daripada soalan semester yang baru ni, baru berlalu. Kita tengok soalan consolidated statement of cash flow dulu. Okey, soalan cash flow adalah soalan 2 ya. Soalan 2 ya. Soalan cash flow. Okey, Sonic Berhad incorporated 15 years ago had diversified its activities and expanded its operations by acquisitions of shares in subsidiaries and associate companies. Accounts for all companies are made up to 31st December. The consolidated financial statement of Sonic Berhad as at 31st December 2021 and its comparative figures are as follows. Okay. So we are given one set of consolidated statement of profit. Okay, sorry. Okay. So, okay. Kita ulang balik lah. Okay, saya ulang balik. Kan dah buka mic tadi. Jadi saya cakap banyak-banyak tadi tak dengar dah ya. Okay, so question 2. Sonic Berhad incorporated 15 years ago had diversified its activities and expanded its operations by acquisitions of shares in subsidiaries and associate companies. Accounts for all companies are made up to 31st December. The consolidated financial statement of Sonic Berhad as at 31st December 2021 and its comparative figures are as follows. Okay. Dia auto turn off ke apa ni? Okay, nanti bagi tahu lagi ya kalau katakan mati lagi.
Okay, sir.
Yeah. Okay, so revenue 106.6 million, cost of sale 60.6 million, gross profit 46 million, operating expenses 31.2 million, finance cost 40,000, share of profit of associate 1.2 million, profit before tax 15.96 million. Taxation 2.5 million and profit after tax 13.46 million. And then profit after tax attributable to owners of the parent 12,425,000, non-controlling interest 1.035 million. And okay, we can see here 13.46 million is the total profit for the year. And then we are also given two sets of statement of financial position for 2020 and 2021, yeah. Okay, so 2020 is opening balance, 2021 is closing balance. You can see from here the movement in property plant equipment. Okay, there is an increase in property plant equipment, there is a decrease in development cost, there is an increase in investment in associate, and then goodwill on consolidation decrease. Why is it decrease? Okay, kita akan dapat dia jawapan nanti. Inventory decrease, trade receivable decrease also, cash and cash equivalent increase. Ha, banyak pula tu ya. Okay, so ada kemungkinannya dia jual investment in subsidiary. Okay, kita tengok NCI. Kita nak buktikan NCI dia berapa. NCI turun. Ada kemungkinan besarnya kat situ dia jual subsidiary dia. Okay. Ordinary shares increase by more than 10 million. Retained profit increase also by about 10 million. Asset revaluation reserve decrease. Non-controlling interest. Okay, tadi kita kata decrease by 2 million. Trade payable decrease. Deferred tax liability increase. Macamlah ada tanda-tanda dia jual subsidiary dia. Okay. Additional information, the operating expenses include depreciation charge on property, plant, equipment 1.75 million, impairment of investment in associate 200,000, impairment of goodwill 5,760,000, and impairment of development cost. Oh, banyak ni. And gain on sale of machine. Ada berapa ni? Kita check dulu. Masing-masing ni nanti kita nak kena masuk dalam operating expense ya. Yang pertama depreciation, yang kedua impairment of investment in associate, yang ketiga impairment of goodwill, yang keempat impairment of development cost, dan yang kelima ada gain on sale of machine. Ada lima perkara yang termasuk di dalam operating expenses. During the year, a machine with a carrying value of 5 million was disposed of for 6 million. Kita dah jumpa dah satu-satu ya. Okay, carrying value 5 million, kita jual pada harga 6 million. Okay, so itu gain sebanyak 1 million. In addition, Sonic has acquired equipment at fair value of 500,000 and the acquisition was reserved through issuance of ordinary shares. Jadi ordinary shares increase partly because of this. Okay, tapi bakinya, okay, bakinya, sekejap ya. Freehold land was revalued at deficit of 900,000 during the year. Okay. The land had previously been revalued and the asset revaluation surplus is related to the land. Okay. Jadi kita tengok tadi ada decrease in asset revaluation reserve. Rupanya disebabkan oleh decrease in fair value of land. Okay. So land tadi revalued kemudian deficit 900,000. Okay, kemudian during the first quarter of the year, the group has spent a further 700,000 to complete the development project. Commercial production commenced in second quarter of the year. However, sales of the new product proved disappointing and on 31st December 2021, the development costs were written down to 1.5 million via impairment charge. Okay, jadi impairment sebanyak 1.5 ni, ini pun menjawab salah satu daripada additional information number one. Yeah, impairment tu, dia kata impairment of development cost 1.5 million. Okay, nombor 4. On 1st January 2021, Sonic Berhad acquired 75% interest in Tunggak Berhad. The consideration was settled partly by issuing ordinary shares in Sonic Berhad at fair value of 6.5 million. And immediate cash. Okay, the fair value of the net asset of Tunggak Berhad at the date of acquisition was as follows. Okay, so mula-mula ingatkan dia ada jual subsidiary, rupanya beli subsidiary. Yeah, acquired 75% interest in Tunggak Berhad. The consideration was settled partly by issuing shares at fair value of 6.5 million and immediate cash. The fair value of the net asset of Tunggak Berhad at the date of acquisition was as follows. Okay, jadi kita akan calculate lah nanti goodwill dia berapa ya. Okay, then property plan equipment 3.5 million, inventory 1.1 million, trade receivable 500,000, cash at bank 700,000, trade payable 300,000 negative ya, tax payable pun negative juga 200,000. The non-controlling interest was measured at its proportionate share of the fair value of the subsidiaries identifiable net asset on the date of acquisition. Okay, so yang pertama, determine the cash consideration from the acquisition of Tunggak Berhad on 1st January 2021 by marks, and B, prepare the consolidated statement of cash flow of Sonic Berhad for the year ended 31st December 2021 using the indirect method. Okay. Soalan dia melayakkan kita untuk buat direct method ya, tetapi dia minta kita buat indirect method. Okay. So first, we need to calculate the cash consideration. Ha, jadi sebenarnya kita calculate goodwill lah ya. Bila kita calculate goodwill tu, ha, kat situ kita akan dapat dia punya apa ni? Dia punya cash consideration. Ya, cash consideration. Okay, kita tengok apakah jawapan dia. Okey, jadi bila kita kira kita punya goodwill, kita akan dapatlah berapakah sebenarnya amount dia dalam cash, cash consideration. Okey, jadi from the question, consideration transfer, total dia adalah 8235. Kemudian kita dapatkan fair value of net asset tadi, ada senarai asset dan liability. Okay, 3.5 million, 1.1 million, 500,000, 700,000. Kemudian account payable tadi 200,000 dan tax payable 300,000. totalnya 5.3 million, 5.3 million. Okey, kemudian kemudian kita punya non-controlling interest, non-controlling interest 5.3 million times 25%. 5.3 million times 25%, kita dapat 1325, 1325. So fair value of investment 8235, okay, plus 1325 equal to 9560. Kemudian kita tolak dengan fair value of invest, fair value of net asset 5300, dan kita dapat goodwill 4260. Eh, 4260. Okey. Jadi ini dia punya goodwill lah, 4260. Dan last sekali kita nak dapatkan dia punya cash consideration. Cash consideration 8325 tolak dengan consideration in term of ordinary share 6500. So kita dapatlah kita punya cash consideration sebanyak 1735. Ya, 1735. Okey, jadi kalau ini kita nak tunjukkanlah macam mana dalam account goodwill tu. Okey. Goodwill brought down asalnya 2500, kemudian carried down 1000. Ya. Yeah. Balance brought down 2500, carried down 1000, kemudian goodwill yang baru daripada acquisition of S 4260, dan kita dapati kat sini impairment dia sebanyak 5760, 5760 ni adalah impairment. Okey, 5760 adalah impairment. Jadi yang kita nak cari 5 markah tadi adalah kita nak cari cash consideration. Okey, seterusnya. Seterusnya kita teruskan dengan consolidated statement of cash flow, ya. Yeah. Consolidated statement of cash flow. Jadi untuk nak dapatkan net cash flow from operating activities, kita memerlukan maklumat yang banyak, ya. Yeah. Maklumat yang banyak. Okay, from the question just now, the profit before tax is 15,690,000. Kemudian kita adjust dengan depreciation. Adjustment on depreciation ni additional information number 1, ya. 1750. Kemudian impairment of goodwill tadi, kita daripada calculation tadi, kita dapat dah impairment of goodwill 5760. Okay, impairment of associate ni disebut juga dalam tu, associate was impaired by 200. Associate was impaired by 200. So semua ni kita campur balik, ya. Depreciation campur balik, impairment of goodwill campur balik, impairment of associate campur balik. And then impairment of development cost also given in the additional information. Okay, 1500. Okay, so kita campur balik. Finance cost 40, campur balik. And then share of profit of associate kita tolak balik, dan gain on disposal of PPE kita tolak balik. Okay, jadi sebenarnya semua information tu dah ada dalam kita punya additional information. So kita dapatlah profit before working capital changes, yeah, operating profit before working capital changes. Next, kita nak tengok pula, yeah, changes in working capital. Kita ada berapa item? Ada 3 item: inventory, trade receivable dan trade payable. Okay, inventory, trade receivable dan trade payable. Okay, so kita punya inventory. Inventory kita opening balance 6,000, closing balance 4,500. Okay, tapi pada masa yang sama kita ada acquire subsidiary, dan subsidiary tadi ada 1,100,000 inventories. So 6,000,000 plus 1,100,000 minus 4.5 million, kita dapatlah, ya, yeah, inventories decrease, ya, yeah, 2.6 million. So decrease is inflow. Okay, decrease is an inflow. And then trade receivable. Trade receivable starts with 3.75 million. Kemudian ada subsidiary baru masuk, 500,000. Kita tolak dengan closing inventory, 3,500. Okay. Jadi yang ni pun decrease juga. So decrease by 750 is inflow. Okay. At the same time, trade payable also decrease. Trade payable, opening balance 1,675. Kemudian masuk subsidiary baru, 300. Kita tolak dengan closing balance 1 million. Okay. Jadi kita dapat decrease 1,065. 1,065,000 decrease. Decrease in current liability means outflow. Okay, outflow. Jadi outflow 1,065. So, kita dapat jawapan dia 23,010 plus 2,600 plus 750 minus 1,065. Kita dapatlah cash generated from operations yang sebanyak 25,295. Yeah, 25,295. Okay. Kemudian tax paid. Tax paid ya. Yeah. Jadi kita tengok tax paid. Tax paid ni dia ada, dia punya opening balance dan closing balance kan. Kita tengok tax kejap. Okay, tax kat sini. Okay, kita ada account tax ya. Yeah. Taxation balance breakdown ni. Balance breakdown 4,500. Okay. Kemudian tax for the year 2,500. Kemudian acquisition of subsidiary dia ada baki 200. Ya. Yeah. Kemudian balance credit down 5,500. Dan balancing figure ni adalah bank lah. Balancing figure bank sebanyak 1,700 balancing figure. Okay. Balancing figure bank sebanyak 1,700. So 1,700 lah amount yang dibayar. Eh, amount yang dibayar. Kemudian interest paid. Interest paid ni dia hanya satu item saja interest ni. Dalam SOPL saja ada interest. Dalam SOFP tak ada interest. Yeah. Dalam subsidiary baru pun tak ada interest. Jadi interest ada satu saja dia punya angka dan angka itulah yang dibayar. Interest expense sama dengan interest paid. Yeah. Sebab dalam SOPL ada satu item 40,000. Dalam SOFP opening balance tak ada, closing balance tak ada. Okay. Jadi itulah dia interest paid. So after add and minus, okay, kita dapat net cash flow from operating activities 23,555. Okay, 23,555. Eh. Jadi kita boleh letak kat sini net cash inflow from operating activities. Is that okay, class?
Okay, sir.
And then we continue with cash flow from investing activities. Yeah. From investing activities, kita tengok daripada additional information tadi ada a few items lah. Dia kata ada purchase of property plant equipment. Okay. Ada disposal of property plant equipment. Ada acquisition of subsidiary. Yeah. Ada payment of development cost. Okay. Dividend from associate ni kita kena cari. Dia tak sebut pun kata dividend in associate. Jadi kita tengok opening balance of associate, closing balance of associate, kemudian share of profit of associate during the year, kemudian ada impairment of associate, daripada situlah kita akan dapat dividend from associate. Okay. Jadi daripada additional information, kita ada disposal of property plant equipment. Okay. So disposal of property plant equipment, straight away we can put here 6 million. Tadi dia punya carrying amount 5 million. Depend disposal value 6 million. Kita masukkan 6 million. Okay, yang 5 million kita akan masuk dalam credit side of property plant and equipment. Okay, kita tengok dulu property plant equipment account ni apa yang berlaku. Okay. So in property plant equipment, the balance brought down is 21,750. And the carried down is 31,800. Jadi kita nampak sebenarnya kat situ ada increase sebanyak 10 million. Okay. Tapi increase tadi bukan saja disebabkan oleh purchase, tetapi increase tadi disebabkan ada acquisition of subsidiary, kemudian ada juga disposal, ada depreciation, ada ARR deficit. Okey, kita tengok satu-satu ya. Okey. Yang pertamanya, okey, selepas balance brought down, balance carried down kita masukkan, kita ada first item iaitu acquisition of subsidiary. The subsidiary brings 3.5 million property plant and equipment masuk sini. Okey. Kemudian yang kedua, kita ada purchase of property plant equipment via issue of shares sebanyak 500,000. Okey. Kemudian kita ada disposal tadi carrying amount 5 million. And then we have depreciation 1750. And lastly we have deficit on revaluation 900,000. So after we plus and minus, yeah, kita dapati bahawa balancing figure ni adalah di sebelah kiri ni, balancing figure. Balancing figure di sebelah kiri ni iaitu apa dia? Bank kan. Jadi banyak tu sebenarnya 13,700,000. Eh, 13,700,000. Yang lain-lain ni dia bagi tahu pada kita, ya. Yeah? Ada acquisition of subsidiary, ada purchase by way of issue of shares, semua tu. Tapi yang bank ni dia tak bagi tahu. Banyak tu. Ya, yeah? 13.7 million. So 13.7 million is the purchase of property plant and equipment. Kita masukkan di atas. Ya, yeah? 13.7 million purchase of property plant and equipment. So kita dah dua dah. Acquire property plant equipment, disperse property plant equipment. Yang ketiga, acquisition of subsidiary. Ya, yeah, acquisition of subsidiary. Kita dapat angka tunai tadi daripada atas. Angka tunai 1735. Ya. Yeah? 1735 kita bayar. Tetapi kita dapat, kita dapati bahawa subsidiary tadi ada cash. Subsidiary ada cash juga. Eh, sebanyak 700,000. Jadi kita bayar 1735, kita dapat tunai daripada subsidiary 700. Okey. Jadi sebenarnya dia punya net outflow adalah 1035. Okey, 1035. Then development cost paid. Development cost paid, kita telah diberitahu tadi berapa banyak dia bayar, 700. Okey, 700. Kemudian dividend from associate kita kena cari. Kita buka associate account, kita tengok tengok opening balance, kita tengok closing balance. Okey, opening balance is 4.3 million, closing balance 4.72 million. Okey, kemudian share of profit ni daripada statement of profit or loss 1.2 million. Kemudian kita ada impairment loss 200,000. Dan balancing figure dia adalah bank di sini, ya. Eh? Bank 580 ni, ni adalah balancing figure. So balancing figure ni sebenarnya adalah dividend paid by associate. Ya, yes? Banyak tu, 580,000. 580,000. Share of profit 1200. Bayar dividend 580. Okay, kelas. Seterusnya kita pergi pada item yang berikutnya iaitu, okey, untuk investing activities dah habis dah. Investing activities kita dapat net cash flow from investing activities 8855, ya. Yeah. Maknanya majority of the transaction in the investing activities are outflow, ya. Yeah. 13.7 million tu yang menyebabkan dia jadi negatif tu. Kalau 13.7 million tu tak ada, kita akan dapat negatif lah. Okay. Kemudian layer yang ketiga, cash flow from financing activities. Ya, yeah, from financing activities kita tengoklah. Yang pertamanya movement in ordinary share capital. Okay. Kemudian dividend paid to non-controlling interest dan dividend paid by holding company. Kita tengok yang pertama, movement in share capital. Movement in share capital. Okey, kita tengok ordinary share capital. Opening balance 17500. Closing balance 27,940. Okay. Kemudian acquisition of subsidiary kita bayar dengan ordinary share 6.5 million. Kemudian kita beli property plant equipment dengan ordinary share 500,000. Okay. Masih lagi tak dapat 27,940. Jadi balancing figure dia adalah 3,440. 3,440 ni adalah issue of shares for cash. Issue of shares for cash. Alright. Itu yang pertama lah ya. Kemudian yang kedua, dividend to non-controlling interest. Kita buka non-controlling interest account. Non-controlling interest account, balance brought down is 6 million. Carried down is 4 million. Okay. Kemudian, NCI for acquisition of new subsidiary 1,325. And then share of profit for share of profit from the subsidiary. Okay, based on statement of profit or loss 1,035. Yeah, 1,035. Jadi kita dapati balancing figure dia adalah 4,360,000. 4,360,000. Banyak betul dia bayar dividen kepada NCI. Eh? Walaupun sebenarnya tak logik lah. Dari segi itu tak logik. Eh? Tak logik lah. Profit dia baru 1,035. Eh? Profit baru 1,035 tapi bayar dividen 4,360. Tapi kita bukan nak tengok logik dia lah. Kita nak tengok flow tu dalam NCI balancing figure dia memang payment of dividend. Payment of dividend tu non-controlling interest lah by the subsidiary. Okay, by the subsidiary. Okay, kemudian yang seterusnya, yang ketiga kita ada dividend paid by holding. Yeah. Jadi dividend paid by holding ni ada sebut tak dalam soalan? Okay, jadi kalau tak ada sebut, kita tengok kat sini. Retained profit, eh, retained profit of the group. Opening balance of retained profit is 9,235. Closing balance 19,160. And then profit for the year 12,425. 12,425. Jadi sepatutnya kita dapat lebih daripada 19. Yeah, sepatutnya kita dapat lebih daripada 19 lah. Jadi sepatutnya kita punya balance carry down dia 21,660, tapi kita punya balance cuma 19,160. Jadi dia menunjukkan bahawa okay, parent ni dah bayar dividen ya. Parent bayar dividen sebanyak 2.5 juta. 2.5 juta. Ini yang saya kata tak berapa logik ni. Sebab subsidiary bayar dividen kepada NCI 4.36 juta. Tapi parent sendiri pun cuma bayar 2.5 juta. Yeah. Tapi kita jangan fikir sangat yang logik dia tu. Sebab macam ni lah cara kita nak buat statement of cash flow. Okay kelas. Jadi ada apa-apa soalan nak ditanya berkaitan dengan cash flow ni? Okay, development cost tadi kita tak tengok. Development cost, opening balance 2.3 juta. Ya, kemudian carry down 1.5 juta. Impairment sebanyak 1.5 juta. Jadi bank adalah balancing figure. Okey, jadi biasanya soalan cash flow ni almost full mark lah, ataupun full mark ataupun almost full mark eh. 25. Tapi markah dia kurang lah, tak berapa banyak eh. 25 berbanding dengan soalan 1, 75 markah. Okay, ada apa-apa soalan nak tanya? Tak ada? Kita tengok pula soalan teori. Soalan teori ni kita jarang kita bincang soalan teori. Dalam guru projek ada soalan teori lebih kurang macam ni jugalah soalan dia. Tapi ni soalan 1B ni sebanyak 15 markah. Okey. Kita tengok balik soalan dia, soalan 1B. Okey, soalan 1B. Part B eh. A. Pandan berhad and seri muka berhad own 52% and 48% equity shares in lapis berhad. 52 and 48. Okey, bila nampak 52 dengan 48 ni apa dalam kepala kita? 52 is the parent. 48 ni adalah apa dia? NCI lah. Ya kan? Jadi dua pihak ni pandan dengan seri muka. Tapi dia berdua saja. The board of directors in Lapis Berhad has 5 members who control the most significant decisions in the company. Pandan appoints 3 out of 5 while seri muka nominates the CEO in Lapis Berhad. Jadi dua-dua ni power lah. Satu lantik 3 orang. Maknanya 2 orang lagi tu daripada Seri Muka. Kemudian Seri Muka pula dia ada wakil dia sebagai CEO. The CEO reports to and functions under direction of Board of Directors. Jadi CEO ni yang paling berkuasa lah sebenarnya. Okay, kemudian dia melaporkan kepada Board of Directors. Board of Directors pula ada 3 member daripada Pandan, ada 2 member daripada Seri Muka. Required. With reference to the relevant Malaysian financial reporting standards, explain briefly which investor is most likely to control Lapis Berhad. Jadi siapakah yang paling berkuasa? Lapis, dalam lapis ni, Pandan ke Seri Muka? Pandan ke Seri Muka? Jadi kalau berdasarkan kepada cerita yang pendek ni, ada 5 baris saja ni, Pandan ke Seri Muka yang power? Jadi jawapan kita tidak semestinya sama. Jawapan kita tidak semestinya sama. Kita melihat kepada with reference to Malaysian Financial Reporting Standard. Jadi pada pendapat kita, siapakah yang mempunyai kuasa yang lebih? Okay. B pula. Yeah. Hailo Berhad has investment in several subsidiaries. Hailo Berhad own 85% of the issued equity shares in Odele Berhad. 85%, which was acquired for 200 million. Odele Berhad has had 500 million issued equity shares. On 1st October 2021, Pipa Berhad made a private offer to buy 80% of Hailo Berhad interest in Odele Berhad for 455 million. Hailo accepted the offer on 1st October 2021. The financial year end of Hailo Berhad Group is 31st December. Okay. Dia cuma ada, dia ada sebanyak 85%. 85%. Kemudian Pipa ni pula dia beli 80% daripada 85%. 80% of 85%. Jadi 80 of 85 ni maknanya 80 kali 85 ya. Bukan 85 tolak 80. Okay, required. Identify the relationship between Hailo and Odele after the private offer. Jadi selepas dapat private offer tadi, apakah hubungan di antara Odele dengan Hailo? Hailo asalnya parent kan, 85%. Kemudian Hailo ni dapat private offer daripada Pipa untuk membeli 80% daripada 85%. Jadi apakah hubungan di antara Hailo dengan Odele? after the offer, 2 markah. Kemudian, with reference to MFRS 10, Consolidated Financial Statement, explain briefly the effect of the private offer in the Consolidated Financial Statement for the year ended 31 December 2021. Apa berlaku kepada Consolidated Financial Statement? Yeah. Consolidated Financial Statement of High Low Berhad. C. West Berhad acquired 75% equity shares of South Berhad. North Berhad holds 80% equity shares in West Berhad. Okay. West 75% in South. North 80% in West. Okay, jadi North ni atas, paling atas. Ada 80% equity share dalam West. West pula ada 75% shares in South. North Berhad also had 15% equity shares in East. And North is allowed to appoint 2 of East 5 directors. Okay. Ya. Yeah. Kita nampak kedudukan dia. North. North ni atas sekali. Bawah North ada West. Ya. Yeah, bawah North ada West. Okay. Kemudian bawah West ada South. North, West, South. North pula dia ada satu lagi investment, 15% saja. Tetapi 15% ni pun dia dia boleh melantik 2 daripada 5 directors. Ya, yeah? 5 daripada 2 daripada 5 directors. Number 1, identify the related parties to North Berhad with reference to MFRS 124, related party disclosure. Kemudian yang kedua, explain briefly whether North and West have control, joint control or significant influence in their respective investees. Itulah soalan dia. Ya. Kita tengok jawapan dia. Okey, rasa-rasa boleh jawab tak? 15 markah tadi tu. Boleh dapat 15 ataupun 10 ataupun 12. Ataupun 8.
InsyaAllah.
InsyaAllah. InsyaAllah. Itu jawapan saya nak dengar. Okay. So kita tengok ya. Yang pertama, apakah dia cerita tentang pandan dan juga seri muka tadi. Siapakah yang paling berkuasa ke atas apa nama company tadi? Pelapis. Ya. Yeah. Pandan dengan seri muka, siapakah yang lebih berkuasa ke atas lapis? Ya. Yeah. Pandan Berhad appoints the majority of the board. 3 out of 5. Okay. Poin ni kena ada lah. Kita tulis saja poin-poin yang kita ada. And then, Seri Muka nominates the CEO. CEO ni, dia punya power dia memang power lah. Who has more day-to-day involvement in the operations of Lapis Berhad. Okay. However, Lapis Berhad board oversees both CEO and day-to-day operation and is empowered to direct these activities. Accordingly, it is more likely that Pandan has the ability to direct the relevant activities and therefore control Lapis Berhad. Jadi percentage dia 52 dengan 48. 52-48 tu memanglah daripada mula pun kita boleh kata, okay, Pandan ni is more powerful lah in term of percentage je. Tapi dia tak cerita pun dalam ni pasal percentage. Dia cerita pasal dia punya role kat situ. Yeah? Pandan appoints majority of the board. 3 out of 5. Maksudnya kat situ dah nampak dah dia punya ability to control. Seri Muka nominates the CEO. And the CEO has more day-to-day involvement in operation of Lapis. But, okay, the board of directors is more powerful. Because CEO is reporting to board of directors. And CEO also oversees the day-to-day operations. Jadi maknanya, board of directors ni dia ada kuasa untuk direct the relevant activities of the company. So board of directors dikuasai oleh siapa? Dikuasai oleh Pandan. Jadi siapakah yang lebih berkuasa? Pandan. Dengan meletakkan 3 daripada 5 tadi, dia sangat berkuasa. According to, accordingly, It's more likely that pandan has the ability to direct the relevant activities and therefore controls lapis berhad. Okay. Tapi kalau katakan awak boleh jawab dengan meyakinkan bahawa apa ni seri muka lebih berkuasa kat situ dengan hujah-hujah yang lebih baik, maknanya daripada 5 tadi mungkin awak dapat 3 lah. Ya, mungkin dapat 3. Mungkin juga dapat 4, mungkin juga dapat 5. Tapi memang kalau kita tengok dari segi analisisnya, memang pandan yang lebih berkuasa. Kita analyze ni kita tengok one by one lah. Bila kita tengok composition of board of directors. Tapi kalau dekat sini, pandan ada 52%, tapi dia cuma boleh melantik 2 daripada 5. 2 daripada 5 dah cerita lain dah. Kalau 2 daripada 5 dia dah cerita lain. Sebab ada 3 directors yang lebih berkuasa daripada 2 directors tadi. Jadi dalam keadaan yang demikian, kalau katakan Seri Muka boleh lantik 3. Seri Muka boleh lantik 3. Maka Seri Muka kat situ lebih berkuasa, dan Seri Muka lah sebenarnya adalah merupakan dia punya holding company. Okay, walaupun pandan ada sebanyak 52%. Jadi kita tengoklah dia punya ciri-ciri yang ada dalam tu. Okay, jadi dalam ni lebih clear kita nampak pandan lebih berkuasa sebab dia appoint 3 members out of 5. Kemudian walaupun Seri Muka boleh lantik CEO, tetapi CEO ni memang ada kuasa day to day involvement in operation, but CEO reports to board of directors. Board of directors comprise of 3 out of 5 daripada pandan. Jadi sebenarnya board of directors lah yang oversee both the CEO, both the operations and also day to day operation. Jadi maknanya board of directors lah yang mempunyai kuasa untuk direct relevant activities of the company. So bila dia direct relevant activities of the company, kita tengok berapakah composition daripada pandan. So composition daripada pandan ada 3. So maknanya pandan is most likely has the ability to direct the relevant activities and therefore control lapis berhad. Right. B number 1. Okay. Persoalannya tadi. Odile mula-mula dikuasai oleh Hilo dengan 85%. Kemudian ada private offer daripada Pipa. Pipa offer kepada Hilo. Dia kata saya nak beli awak punya saham dalam Odile. Okay, sebanyak 80% daripada saham yang awak pegang sekarang ni. So 80% of 85%. Jadi sebenarnya dia beli sebanyak berapa? 80 kali dengan 85%. Berapa tu? 74. Tolong kira sikit. Point 8 times 85 68 68%. Dia beli 68. Jadi maknanya sekarang ni Pipa mempunyai 68% pegangan saham di dalam Odile. Manakala Hilo ni dia ada 17%. 17% sahaja. Okey, jadi apakah jawapan dia? On 1 October 2021, Odile is just a simple investment to Hilo Berhad. Since Hilo's interest in Odile is now reduced to only 17%. Jadi relationship dia sebagai simple investment. Tak ada relationship lah. Simple investment saja. Okey. Kemudian yang kedua, apa kesan private offer tadi terhadap consolidated financial statement? The private offer of 340 million shares, that is 80% of Hilo interest of 425 million shares, reduces high low interest in Odelay to 17%. Ini dah cerita dekat atas tadi, tinggal 70%. The remaining 85% of the issued 500,000 million shares. Hence, Hilo lost control over Odelay. Lost control over Odelay. Hilo Berhad will cease to consolidate Odelay from 1st October 2021. Hilo Berhad will recognize the investment retained in the former subsidiary as simple investment at its fair value at the date when the loss, when the control is lost. Okay. Jadi sambungan daripada atas tadi kita dah tahu dah, dia dah lost control, tinggal 17%. So 17% ni kalau masih dia layak melantik, dia boleh layak melantik lagi members in the board of directors, mungkin boleh lagi dia menjadi associate. Tapi tak ada sebut dalam soalan. Tak ada sebut dalam soalan dia ada significant influence ke, tak ada kan. Jadi apakah kesannya terhadap financial statement? Kesannya, kena stop consolidate. Kena stop consolidate. Bermula daripada 1 Oktober 2021. Kemudian, Hilo nak recognize investment in retain, investment retain in the former subsidiary as simple investment. Jadi seingat saya semasa saya menanda kertas jawapan ni pada semester lepas, kebanyakan student menganggap bahawa Odelay ni adalah associate. Odelay ni sebagai associate dan dikata dikata investment in Odelay ni kita kena record dia based on equity method. Jadi maknanya kita kena perhati betul-betul lah ya. Kita kena perhati betul-betul, tinggal 17% saja. 17% ni tidak melayakkan untuk dia menjadi associate. Dia hanyalah merupakan simple investment, kecuali ada satu ayat lain yang mengatakan Hilo has significant influence ataupun Hilo may appoint two out of five members in the board of directors. Kat situ. Okay, kemudian soalan C. West Berhad being directly subsidiary, being direct subsidiary, West direct subsidiary and South indirect subsidiary to North. Okay, jadi kita kena tengok dulu kat sini, jawapan dia tak semestinya begini. Jawapan dia tak semestinya begini. Macam saya, bila saya baca soalan tadi, saya sebutkan walaupun dia bermula dengan West. Okay, West. Bermula dengan West, kemudian ada South. Jadi North tu kemudian dia cerita. Tapi kita susun balik, kita tengok siapakah yang paling berkuasa. Siapakah yang paling berkuasa kat sini. Jadi North ni dia ada, ada kuasa paling besar sebab dia adalah ultimate parent. North adalah ultimate parent berdasar pada soalan tadi. Jadi kita tengok kat sini, West direct subsidiary of North. South being indirect subsidiary to North. Jadi cerita dia North sebenarnya. North adalah parent. North is the parent to West. Kemudian South is indirect subsidiary to North. Okay, is an associate to North. Jadi sekarang ni siapa yang merupakan related party to North? Yang related party to North, yang pertamanya adalah South. So South ni adalah related party to North sebab dia adalah indirect subsidiary. Yang keduanya adalah associate. Associate pun merupakan related party to North. Okay. Tapi masa exam tu biasanya kita tak boleh lah nak jawab macam ni kan. Jadi kita kena ingat kat situ siapa dia punya ultimate parent, kemudian siapakah dia punya subsidiary. Okay. Jadi yang maknanya yang menjadi direct subsidiary itu kita taklah kata dia sebagai related party. Ya, yang kita kata related party ini adalah indirect subsidiary dan juga associate. Ha, jadi kita susunlah elok-elok tu. Ya. Kita dapat kat situ ada 4 tick untuk 2 markah. Kemudian yang kedua, by acquiring more than 50% of investees equity share. By acquiring more than 50% of investees equity share, North Berhad has control over West. Betul eh? Has control over West. West has control over South. As its own, it owns more than 50% of the equity shares of South. As West is controlled by North, North Berhad is also controlled by control over South. Jadi as West control by North, North also control South. North is the ultimate parent who will present the consolidated financial statement. As for North investment in East, even though the interest held is 15%, North has been allowed to appoint 2 of East 5 directors, which indicates that North has significant influence in East and will be able to participate in East financial and operating decision. Therefore, East is considered as an associate company of North and accounted for using the equity method in accordance with MFRS 128, investment in associate and joint venture. Jadi begitulah eh, kita dapat kalau kita dapat memahami apa yang dikendaki oleh soalan. Tetapi kita fahamlah dalam peperiksaan ni masa dia tak macam dalam perbincangan ni. Dalam perbincangan kita boleh fikir dengan baik kan. Dalam peperiksaan soalan 1A tu pun dah cukup panjang lah. Soalan 1A cukup panjang untuk kita kurang berfikir untuk soalan B ni. Okay, jadi buatlah sedaya upaya eh. Masa kita discuss ni mungkin kita boleh berfikir dengan tenang dan boleh dapat 52 markah eh. Tapi masa dalam peperiksaan yang sebenar, masa biasanya tidak mencukupi. Eh, masa biasanya tidak mencukupi. Okey, ada apa-apa soalan berkaitan dengan soalan teori ni? Apa ada apa-apa nak clarify? Okey, tak ada. Kita cuba pula tengok soalan 1A. Soalan 1A. Okay, soalan 1A adalah soalan full set. Statement of financial position, statement of profit or loss, statement of changes in equity dengan segala macam working dia. Kalau kita tengok soalan dia lebih kurang dengan soalan group project 1 ya. Okey. Tak apa, kita baca dulu setakat mana yang boleh. Kalau tak sempat habis, kita akan sambung pada hari Khamis ya. Part A, introduction. The primary activities of Rosid Berhad are manufacturing, sale, trading, distribution of frozen food product in Malaysia. The company has become one of the leading exporters and largest manufacturers of frozen Asian culinary delight worldwide. Despite setbacks during the COVID-19 pandemic, the company managed to deliver a good performance for the financial year 2021. Rosid Berhad has equity interest in Supreme Berhad, Nutri Berhad and Crest Berhad. Investment in Supreme. Rozib gained control over Supreme by acquiring 90% of Supreme Berhad ordinary shares on 1st January 2019 when the retained earning and other reserve of Supreme Berhad were 2.5 million and 2 million respectively. The consideration for the business acquisition had been satisfied ataupun settled. At the date of acquisition, the carrying amount of Supreme Berhad net asset reflect the fair value, except for a property whose fair value was 1 million above the carrying amount. No adjustment was made in the books of Supreme Berhad to reflect this value. On 1st April 2021, Rozib disposed of 20% of its ordinary shares in Supreme Berhad for, for cash consideration of 6 million. This transaction has not been recorded yet. Mula-mula dia beli 90%. Dia beli 90% pada 1 Januari 2019. Kemudian pada tahun semasa dia jual 20%. Ya. 20% daripada ordinary share dalam Supreme. Okey. Yang kedua, investment in Nutri. On 1st January 2021, Rozib acquired 65% interest in ordinary share capital of Nutri for 12 million. Revaluation of Nutri. Net asset on the date of acquisition indicated that the fair value was equal to the carrying amount. However, on that date, Rozib also valued Nutri Berhad customer list, which Nutri Berhad has not recognized as any tangible asset at fair value of 0.2 million. It was to be amortized over 5 years. Okay. Jadi ini pun ada fair value adjustment. 200,000. Investment in CRES. Rozib acquired 25% of CRES Berhad ordinary share on 1st January 2020. On that date, the retained profit of CRES Berhad stood at 1 million and the fair value of CRES Berhad net asset was equal to the carrying amount. With this interest, Rozib was able to exercise significant influence over decision on relevant activities of CRES Berhad. Okay. Jadi ada dua subsidiary dan ada satu associate. Financial statement. Statement of financial position dulu. Okay. Tengok perkara yang penting-penting ya. Perkara-perkara penting kat situ. Sini ya, kita tengok investment in subsidiaries, investment in associate. Ini adalah perkara-perkara yang penting ya. Dan ada juga ada investment. Okey, kemudian kita ada inventory, trade receivable, bill receivable, bank. Share capital ni pun penting, kita tengok kat sini share capital. Jadi yang kata 90% lah, 65% lah, 20% lah daripada sini lah ya. Dia beli 90% tadi. Dan jual 20%. Sini pula dia beli 65%. Sini pula dia beli berapa tadi? How many percent sebagai associate. Dan reserve dia kat situ. Dan current liabilities. Okay, yang penting kat sini. Okay, kita ada preference dividend, ordinary dividend. Preferred dividend, ordinary dividend. Statement of profit or loss, revenue, cost of sale, other income, investment income. Okay, so investment income ni ada kemungkinan besarnya investment income daripada subsidiary. Okay, operating expenses, finance cost, profit before tax, surplus on revaluation. Statement of changes in equity. Okay, kita tengok kat sini yang bayar dividend adalah Rozib. Okay, Rozib is the parent, dia bayar dividend, ordinary dan preference. Kemudian supreme, dibayar dividen, ordinary dan preference. Nutri pun bayar dividen, ordinary. Crest tak ada bayar dividen. Additional information, number one, on 1st October 2021, Nutri Berhad sold equipment to Frozit. Had a gain of 0.2 million. Nutri Berhad statement of profit or loss and other comprehensive income recognize the gain as other income. Okay, jadi other income tu dia ada termasuk di dalam the unrealized profit. Kemudian remaining useful life of the equipment on the date of disposal was 2 years. Okay, jadi kat situ ada over provided depreciation ni sebanyak 200,000 bagi dengan 2. Number 2, throughout the current year, Supreme Berhad had purchased goods worth 7.8 million on credit from Prozit. As of 31st December 21, Supreme Berhad still held 2.6 million of inventory supplied by Prozit. Okay, jadi masih ada lagi unrealized profit kat situ. Prozit and Supreme Berhad also not settle 0.65 million of the amount. Okay, 0.65 ni adalah intercompany balance. Intercompany balance. Okay, jadi kat sini ada beberapa perkara yang kita kena adjust. Yang pertama, dalam SOPL kita ada intercompany sale 7.8. Kita ada intercompany purchase 7.8. Okay. Kemudian masih ada lagi unrealized profit daripada unsold goods ni 2.6 juta kali percentage. Percentage dia dekat bawah nanti. Kemudian yang ketiga, dia ada intercompany balance. Account receivable, account payable sebanyak 0.65 juta. Number 3, Frozit sold goods worth 3 million to Crest. Crest ni adalah associate during the year. As of 31st December 2021, 1 million worth of this good remain in Crest company. Okay, jadi ada juga unrealized profit di antara Frozit dengan dia punya associate. Number 4, half of the bill payable of Nutri were drawn in favor of Frozit. Frozit Berhad has discounted 0.14 million of these bills. Jadi ada baki lagi ya. Baki lagi. Bakinya itulah yang kita jadikan sebagai intercompany. Number 5. On 1st January 2020, Frozit Berhad grants 30 share option to its 200 employees. The option only vests if the employee remain employed by Frozit Berhad for 3 years from the grant date. Jadi ini adalah apa yang kita panggil sebagai share option kepada employee. Jadi maknanya employee yang layak untuk dapat ni adalah employee yang remain employed within 3 years from the grant date. The option are exercisable after 1st July 23. The fair value of each option was 20 at the grant date. In the year ended 31st December 2020, 30 employees left Frozit. On 31st December 2021, 10 employees had left. And it was expected that another 40 employees would resign over the following 2 years. Frozit Berhad has not accounted for the transaction in the book for the period. Okay. Jadi yang itu, ni adalah daripada kod FAR 570 570 share option. Okay, jadi yang ni kena kira lah share option ni. Okay, kemudian number 6, included in intangible asset of Frozit Berhad is an intellectual property which cost 1 million. Intellectual property which cost 1 million with an indefinite useful life. The recoverable amount of the intellectual property at 31st December 2021 was 0.75 million. Rosit Berhad has not amended its book to reflect its recoverable amount. Number 7, goodwill on acquisition of Supreme was impaired by 0.1 million and 0.6 million for the ended 31st December 2020 and 21. Okay, yang itu untuk Supreme ya. Number 8. All companies declared a dividend on ordinary shares and preference shares on 30th December 2021. Frozit had not recognized any receivable from its subsidiary. Dia belum recognize lagi. Ya, belum recognize lagi. All profits or loss were deemed to accrue evenly throughout the year. Okay. Kita tengok group policy. Okay, policy. Number one, measure the non-controlling interest at its proportionate share of the fair value of the net asset of the subsidiaries at the acquisition date. Okay, ini masa kita nak calculate goodwill nanti. Kemudian yang kedua, depreciate its property, plant, equipment using straight line method on a yearly basis, charging full year depreciation in the year of purchase and none in the year of disposal. Dan yang ketiga, all intercompany sales are marked up by 20% on sale value. Ya, marked up by 20% on sale value. Okey, apa maknanya? Jadi soalan ni mengelirukan ya, dia kata marked up tapi on sale value. Yeah. Markup on sale value. Jadi adakah dia markup ke dia margin? Ya, yeah, markup ke margin? On sale value. Okay, kemudian required. Banyaklah requirement ni sebab 60 markah kan. Itu dia 60 markah. Yeah. Compute the goodwill or bargain purchase of the acquisition of Supreme Berhad for marks. Compute the goodwill or bargain purchase of acquisition of Nutri for marks. Compute gain on sale of shares in Supreme for marks. Prepare consolidated statement of profit or loss and other comprehensive income. 21 markah. Prepare consolidated statement of changes in equity 10 markah. Prepare consolidated statement of financial position of Rosit Group 17 marks. Okay, jadi kita ada masa lagi, kita boleh tengok eh. Kita tengok jawapan dia, kita tengoklah dulu at least eh, calculation of goodwill ya, eh, bagian goodwill, kemudian compute gain or loss on disposal. Kita tengoklah setakat mana yang kita boleh. Okay, kita bermula dengan goodwill or bargain purchase for acquisition of Supreme Berhad. Okay. Jadi, yeah, consideration transferred. Yeah, consideration transferred untuk Supreme Berhad. Okay, macam mana kita boleh dapat consideration transferred untuk Supreme Berhad? 23.76. Okay. Kita tengok semula soalan sekejap. Saya saja boleh tengok, awak tak boleh tengok. Supreme Berhad. Okey, jadi kita tolak 12 tu sebab yang 12 tu adalah investment in Nutri. Jadi maknanya total investment yang kita ada dalam akaun Frozen ni, kita kena tolak 35.76 ni, kita tolak 12 sebab yang 12 adalah investment in Nutri. Okey, jadi betul lah yang tadi tu. Kita tolak 12 sebab 12 adalah investment in Nutri. So 23.76. Kemudian fair value of net asset, ordinary share capital 20 million. Retain profit 2.5 million. Other reserve 2 million. And revaluation reserve of property 1 million. Total fair value of net asset is 25.5 million. NCR is 10% of 25.5 million. Equal to 2.55 million. Plus 23.76 equal to 26.31 million fair value of investment. Compare with fair value of net asset 25.5, goodwill is 0.81 million. Impairment, ada impairment dua kali. Pada tahun lepas 0.1 juta, pada tahun ni adalah 60,000. So remaining goodwill is 0.65 million ataupun 650,000. Okay, next, goodwill or bargain purchase for acquisition of Nutri. So consideration transfer tadi adalah 12 million, very clear, 12 million. Kemudian fair value of net asset, ordinary share capital 15 million. Okay, retained profit dia, retained profit brought down 2.61 million. Retained profit for the year, yeah, retained profit for the year 5.64 juta kali dengan 6/12 ni, sebab acquisition berlaku pada satu hari bulan Julai. So, yeah, kita punya retained profit on the date of acquisition is 5.43. Kemudian kita ada revaluation reserve ataupun fair value adjustment untuk customer list sebanyak 200,000. So total fair value of net asset is 20.63 million. NCR is 35% times 20.63 million equal to 7.22 million. Plus 12 million consideration transfer equal to 19.22 million fair value of investment. Kita compare dengan fair value of net asset 20.63. So kita dapat bargain purchase. So bargain purchase di sini adalah keuntungan, ya. Keuntungan pada tahun semasa, bargain purchase 1.41 million because you are paying less. Seterusnya C, gain on disposal of shares in Supreme Berhad. Sale proceed. Sale proceed 6 million. 20% tadi 6 million. Okay. Kita tengok kat sini. Fair value of net asset of S on the date of disposal, ordinary share is 20 million. Okay, retained profit brought down 6.6 million. Current year kali 3 bulan, 7.25 times 3 over 12. So kita dapat totalnya 8.41. Ada reserve adalah 2. Revaluation reserve property tadi 1 million. Okay, 1 million. Kemudian kita kali dengan 18%. Okay, 18%. Okay, dia kata dijual sebanyak 20%, ya. Jadi 20% daripada 90%. 20% daripada 90% adalah 18%. Okay, so 31.41 times 18% dapatlah 5.65 million. Okay, 5.65 million. Proceed, sale proceeds 6 million. Fair value of net asset untuk 18%, 5.65, dapatlah gain on disposal of share sebanyak 0.35 million ataupun 350,000. Okay, kelas. Next. Ini dia, consolidated statement of profit or loss and other comprehensive income. Okay, I would like to remind you, okay, masa, kalau masa tak cukup, eh, kita campur saja apa yang ada tu, campur, 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 ya. Jangan lupa yang itu. Ada juga yang dah buat masa dalam test tu. Alhamdulillah you follow my advice. Jadi kita jangan sampai kita panik dan tak buat langsung ya. Okey, jadi kalau kita panik pun kita buat juga campur. Jadi kalau ada dua subsidiary, maknanya ada tiga company lah. Parent, subsidiary one, subsidiary two, campur saja. Okey. Masa kalau masa ada lagi kita masukkanlah all the adjustment ya. Okey. Jadi kat sini parent 52 ya. Subsidiary pertama tu adalah 20. Kemudian subsidiary yang kedua tu kita acquire dia pada 1 Julai. Jadi dia punya revenue tu untuk daripada tempoh 1 Julai sampailah 31 Disember. Lepas tu kali 6/12. Okey. Kemudian kita ada intercompany sale 7.8 dan kita juga ada intercompany purchase 7.8 amount yang sama. Okey. Kemudian cost of sale ni 13 million parent, 5 million ni supreme subsidiary ya. Kemudian yang ni adalah subsidiary Nutri. Nutri 4.42 kali 6/12. Itulah intercompany purchase campur balik dengan unrealized profit ya, 0.52. Macam mana dapat 0.52? Ya. Tadi 2.6 juta. 2.6 juta kali dengan 20%. Kali dengan 20% sama dengan 520,000 ya. Jadi okey, keyword kita adalah cost ataupun selling price. Kalau dia sebut cost, profit on cost maknanya markup. Profit on selling price maknanya margin. Jadi soalan tadi memang sengajalah dikelirukan kat situ. Dia kata markup tapi on sale value. Jadi bila sebut perkataan sale value itu adalah margin sebenarnya. Okay. Okay. Kemudian gross profit. Gross profit 60.12. Other income. Okay, other income tadi 0.52 campur 0.4. Kemudian yang ni pula Nutri kali 6/12. Dan kita ada unrealized profit on disposal of property plant equipment tadi 0.2 juta. Dan kesan daripada 0.2 juta ni ada over provided depreciation nanti dalam expenses. Kemudian investment income 13.1. Operating expenses. Operating expenses parent campur dengan supreme campur dengan Nutri kali 6/12. Kemudian amortization. Ingat tadi amortization of apa dan jadi amortization of apa ni, intangible asset. Okay, intangible asset. Kemudian tolak dengan depreciation over provided 0.1. Kemudian ada impairment 0.25. Yang employee benefit ni, ini adalah employee benefit ni adalah berkaitan dengan yang tadi itulah share option tu, ESOS tu ya, employees share option. Kita akan tengok nanti kalau ada calculation dia. And then share of profit of associate 2.48 tolak 0.2 kali dengan 25%. 0.2 ni apa sebenarnya? Ini adalah unrealized profit ya. Proceed jual kepada CRES. Proceed jual kepada CRES dan dapat unrealized profit 0.2. Tapi 0.2 tadi kenalah kali dengan 0.25 ataupun 25%. Okey. Kemudian bagian purchase 1.41, impairment of goodwill for the year 0.06, finance cost, okey. Tak ada apa-apa sebenarnya ya. Parent, supreme, Nutri kali 6/12. Deletion 8.48 campur 2.40, yang ni 1.88 ni Nutri kali 6/12. And then kita ada surplus on revaluation for the year 4.5. Kemudian kita ada changes in shareholding ya, changes in shareholding. Changes in shareholding ni kita dapat gain tadi kan? Kita dapat gain. Ya, kita dapat gain. Gain on disposal of share 0.35. Ya, betul ke tadi? Betul. ya, 0435. Okey, total comprehensive income 41.25. Okey, profit after tax attributable to equity holders of the parent and NCI. NCI kita tengok working sekejap lagi. Okey, ini dia. Kita ada dua subsidiary, Supreme and Nutri. Profit after tax of Supreme from the question is 7.25. Kemudian dia tak ada apa-apa adjustment melainkan preference dividend sebanyak 350,000. So, profit available for ordinary shareholders 6.9 juta. Yeah. Manakala di sini pula Nutri, profit after tax okay, untuk setengah tahun 2.82. Itulah amortization 0.02. Kemudian unrealized profit on equipment 0.2 dan depreciation on equipment separuh daripadanya iaitu 0.1. Okay, total profit available to ordinary shareholders 2.7 million. Okay, kemudian kita tengok NCI in Supreme. NCI in Supreme ya untuk tahun semasa ni daripada 1 Januari sampai 31 Mac. Okay, selama 3 bulan kan? Ya. Yeah. Selama 3 bulan NCI dia adalah 10%. Jadi profit for the year 6.9 kali dengan 10% kali dengan 3/12 dapatlah 170,000. Kemudian daripada 1/4 sampai 31 Disember okey, dia punya percentage adalah 28%. 28% kali dengan 9/12 sampai dengan 1.45 juta. Kemudian preference dividend 100% belong to NCI. Okay, 350,000. So total NCI total NCI daripada Supreme 1.97. Manakala total NCI untuk Nutri 6 bulan. Okay, 6 bulan iaitu 1 Julai until 31 Disember. Okay, 2.7. 0.7 million times 35%. Kita dapat 0.95 juta ataupun 950,000. Jadi totalnya ni lah ya. 1.97 campur 0.95. Itulah amount ya. Non-controlling interest. Profit attributable to non-controlling interest 2.92 juta. Seterusnya. Ini dia. Working for share based payment. Share based payment yang ni awak lagi faham lah ya. Awak belajar dalam FAR 570 kalau tak silap saya. Okay, jadi pada tahun 2020 tu ada 30 option kali dengan 170 employee kali dengan RM20 kali dengan 1/3. So expenses untuk tahun tersebut adalah 0.34. Equity adalah 0.34. Okay. Manakala di sini pula, 31 Disember 2021, 30 option kali dengan 120 employee. Dan sebab dia dah ada yang resign. Jadi 170, sekarang 120. Kali 20, kali 2/3 tolak 0.34. 0.34 ni kita dah ambil daripada yang tahun lepas. Okay. Jadi untuk expenses ada 0.14 manakala equity 0.48 ya. Jadi 0.34 campur 0.14 sama dengan 0.48. Okey. Jadi yang masuk dalam expenses 0.14 masuk dalam equity 0.48 untuk tahun yang semasa. Okey, seterusnya consolidated statement of changes in equity. Kita bermula dengan balance breakdown di bawah. Balance breakdown. Okay, on the date of acquisition, kita ada satu subsidiary baru masa tu. Subsidiary ordinary share 2.55, preference share 7 juta. Ini Supreme ya. Okay, Supreme. Kemudian Retain profit of Supreme. Brought down 6.6. Dan retained earning on the date of acquisition 2.5. Post retain profit 4.1. Okay. 90% pergi dekat group retain profit dan 10% pergi dekat NCI. Seterusnya, Prozit. Prozit, retain profit brought down as per question 19.06. Impairment loss. Impairment loss ni impairment loss of goodwill 0.1 juta. Kemudian share of post loss. Share of post loss. Okay, Crest tu dia acquire pada tahun ni lepas kan. Okay. Kemudian dia ada loss dia. 0.52 tolak 1. Kali dengan 25%. So share of post loss adalah RM120,000. Kembalian employee benefit untuk tahun 2020 adalah 0.34. Okay. Jadi total profit brought forward of Prozit is 18.5. Group retained profit brought down is 22.19 dan NCI adalah 9.96. Okay. Kemudian amount tu kita bawa naik ke atas dalam statement of changes in equity. Balance brought down 22.19. Profit for the year 33.48. Okay. Changes in shareholding in Supreme. Ini adalah gain on disposal. Yeah, gain on disposal of shares in Supreme. Kemudian ordinary dividend parent for preference dividend parent 0.5. Balance carried down 51.52. NCI tadi balance brought down 9.96. Profit for the year 2.92. Acquisition during the year ni adalah acquisition of Nutri 7.22. Changes in shareholding of Supreme. Okey, jadi disebabkan ada berlakunya jualan saham di dalam Supreme, maka NCI telah meningkat sebanyak 5.65. 5.65 ni adalah sebenarnya 18% daripada fair value of net asset of Supreme. 5.65. Kemudian ordinary dividend 0.54 ni sekejap kita tengok, preferred dividend 100%, 0.35. Okey, kita tengok 0.54 macam mana boleh dapat working tu. Jadi untuk dividen ni dividen ni dalam statement of changes in equity kita kena tunjukkan calculation ya. Saya tengok dalam group project tu ramai yang tak tunjuk calculation, tiba-tiba dapat dia punya dividend paid tu. Dividend paid to NCI tu. Jadi mungkin jawapan betul tapi tak ada bukti macam mana kita kira dapat angka tu. Okey. So, ordinary dividend Supreme. 1 juta kali dengan 28% dapatlah 0.28. Nutri pula 0.75 juta kali dengan 35% sama dengan 0.26. So, dapatlah 0.54 juta. Jadi begini, kita kena tunjukkan dia punya calculation of dividend paid to NCI. Okay. Dan last sekali. Okay, last sekali kita settlekan dan current asset kita. Okay, consolidated statement of financial position as at 31 December 2021 dan current asset. Property, plant, equipment ada 3 company ya, yeah. Prozit, Supreme dan Nutri. Okay, kemudian kita ada fair value adjustment ataupun asset revaluation reserve. Okay, kemudian ada underprovided depreciation. Ini bukan underprovided depreciation. Ini adalah unrealized profit. Unrealized profit 0.2 dan 0.1 ni adalah overprovided depreciation. Goodwill 0.65, ada investment. 0.65 goodwill. Ada investment. Okay, tidak ada perubahan apa-apa. Investment in associate, yes. Okay. Okay, investment in associate 3.22 minus 0.12 plus 0.57. Intangible asset. Intangible asset tadi ada yang baru ya, 0.2. Kemudian tolak dengan amortization. Ya. Dan tolak impairment 0.25. Current asset. Inventories, okey. Kita campurkan tiga company, tolak dengan unrealized profit of inventory 0.52. Trade receivable, campur-campur-campur tiga company, tolak dengan 0.65 juta ni adalah intercompany balance. Intercompany balance. Nanti amount yang sama kita akan tolak dalam trade payable. Bill receivable, Prozip Supreme Nutri. Okay. Ini adalah bagi bill payable yang intercompany di antara siapa tadi? Antara Nutri dengan Prozip. Bank. Okay. Supreme. Bank, Prozip, Supreme, Nutri. Kemudian campur 6 ni adalah is it cash in transit? Letak cash in transit. Ordinary share of the parent 80, preference share of the parent 10, retain profit, other reserve, NCI ni datangnya daripada okay, retain profit dan NCI datangnya daripada schedule. Datangnya daripada schedule brought down. Okay, kemudian ada reserve tadi 4.5. 4.5 ni daripada SOPL tadi ya. Ada reserve. Okay, share based payment. Share based payment. Okay, yang equity punya 0.14 ni adalah baki. Okay, 0.14 ni daripada tahun semasa. 0.34 daripada tahun lepas. 0.48. Bank loan campur saja tiga-tiga. Okay, current liabilities, trade payable. Trade payable macam saya sebut tadi ada intercompany balance 0.65. Kemudian kita ada bill payable tolak 0.16, intercompany balance, ordinary dividend. Okey. Ordinary dividend. Ordinary dividend, parent 4. Ya. Yeah. Supreme 1, Nutri 0.75. Kemudian kita tolak dengan the amount of ordinary dividend paid by Supreme. Ya. Yeah. Dibayar oleh Supreme kepada Prozip dan dibayar oleh Nutri kepada Prozip. Kita tolaklah kat sini. Kemudian preference dividend payable 0.5 dan 0.35. 0.35 ni adalah daripada subsidiary lah ya, sebab 100% daripada dia punya preference share dimiliki oleh dan controlling interest. Okey. Jadi kita alhamdulillah kita berjaya menghabiskan 60 markah ni, tapi laju sikitlah. Okey. Jadi itulah dia ya, jawapan untuk soalan final exam yang kita bincang pada pada hari inilah. Okay. Jadi nanti okay, awak boleh tengok baliklah nanti video ni ya, sebagai panduan ya untuk kita menjawab soalan final exam. Okey kelas, ada apa-apa soalan nak tanya?
Tak
ada. Tak ada ya. Jadi kita ada satu jam lagi pada hari Khamis. InsyaAllah hari Khamis tu ada peluang terakhir lah untuk nak bertanya soalan. Bukan maknanya lepas tu tak boleh tanya. Boleh ya. Tapi maknanya dalam kelas yang official tu ada satu jam lagi insyaAllah. Okay. Jadi saya rasa kalau tak ada apa-apa, kita akhiri dulu kelas kita pada hari ini. Okay. Dengan surah Al-As. Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Wal asri innal insana lafi husr. illa ladzina amanu wa amilus salihat wa tawasaw bil haqq wa tawasaw bis sabr. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Waalaikumsalam, sir. Thank you, sir.
Okay, welcome.
Thank you, sir.
Welcome.
Thank you, sir.